Okay, so we got our dock open. Let's go back into it and slide our tandems. Okay. Okay. Seatbelt. Here and turn around some kind of way. I left my tandems forward so it's easier to turn around in this short space. I'm gonna go up here and then circle around to the left because my dock's on the right, or my dock will be on the. So let's come up here, circle around. I want to make sure my tail swing doesn't wipe out those pallets. See how we did for alignment. We're going to go in dock six, which is the one all the way over there. That's fine. Okay, now pop the brakes. I'll show you what we're going to do. Oh, I need my key. Some of the sliding tandems have a handle you pull out. This one has a button you pull out. And watch. Just watch these pins. See them? See how they popped in? I push it back in, they extend back out. Now I pull them back out, pull it back out. See that? Now I push it back in. Watch. It's all air actuated. There's four of these pins. I'll pull it back out. Now, by the same token, I can push. What happens is I pull the red brake handle out, the trailer brake handle out on the dash. And when I push it back in on the dash, it's the same effect as pushing this back in. These pins will come back out because it'll reactivate the air back here. This is some kind of a way to shut the air off and retracts the pins. And in normal everyday use, as soon as you push the red one in, the pins go out. It's a safety, an extra added safety thing. So somebody couldn't just walk up here and pull this out when you're parked at the truck stop. And then as soon as you push the red one in, they're re-engaged back in the hole. See, for safety. Now I've seen these tandems, they slide on this rail. And I've seen the guy when they had the handle pulled out, they left the handle pulled out, or somebody pulled the handle out on him. And he drove down the freeway. I've seen it twice. If they hit the brakes hard enough, the tandems jumped all the way out of the back of the trailer, broke through the ICC bar here, and the tandems were behind them about 100 yards and the trailer was down on the ground. I've seen it happen. So it's with this, you don't have to check it. I mean, you do, but you don't. You do. Of course you do. But not as closely as pull-out handle ones. Doors open. I like to put the handles, stow the handles away, just for neatness. And now we're gonna slide the tandems all the way back and dock it. Got my lock up. Okay. Seatbelt when backing. Seatbelt when the brakes are released. Right. And so I have left the red one out. Because if I push it back in, the pins re-engage, right? I don't want the pins to re-engage. I put it in reverse one time, just make sure everything's loose. It is. Now I go forward on the tractor to slide them back to the rear. See that? Some shade on the camera. See how the trailer is sliding on top of them? They're locked down, the wheels are not turning. The boom, they're all the way to the rear. Now I push the red one in, and the pins go out, remember that. Now, they may not be lined up with the holes right now, so what do? I go in reverse a little bit, and I'm gonna show you a little trick I do, just a little bit. The wheels are turning. Now I pop the red trailer one only. Leave the yellow one pushed in, that's the tractor. And just go enough to where I hear it pop in, they popped in. Why? Because the tractor and trailer is not moving. Push the red one in and dock it. Easy. Cut a little bit too much. She honked, so I honked. Okay. Nice and easy, creeping back. You gotta be careful because you don't want to rip off one of your trailer doors or do something that would prevent you from getting loaded and prevent you from getting paid. Accident reports, you could get fired for things. And so, all kinds of bad things happen when bad things happen, you know what I mean? When I get about 10 feet away from the dock, I like to get on and just walk back there and make sure, triple sure everything's good. There's too much at stake to make a mistake. We're pretty good on this yellow line here with the wheels. Tandems are all the way back, and I'll show you the pins. Pins are back out again, see that? There's four pins. Two. And this looks pretty good. I'm gonna make sure this is lined up with my rubber bumper. Yes, it appears to be inside the yellow line there, see that? Directly down, inside the yellow line. Coming up the trailer. We could stand to go over a little bit, but there's another person docking in here. I don't want to rip it off my door. So I'll stay where I'm at. I think we're good. And we are good, so, okay. It's just a little too much at stake to risk a $100,000 a year job on a, I think it's cliche enough, and then rip your door off or do something bad, tear something up. I've also seen where they left the dock plate up, and then you back into the dock plate and bend it all to heck. And you're gonna have to move over to another dock and then come inside and fill out an accident report. Because you didn't walk back there and check things, see? That's what I'm talking about. See, that's my worry is how thick these reefer doors are. If another driver comes in here too close to my trailer, he could run into my door and rip it off. Okay. Oh yeah, that's brilliant. Oh, those nails sticking out. Yeah, that's gonna be just fine. It looks like the dock lock is almost direct center of the ICC bar, DOT bar, bumper. That looks good. I like it much. Now we just gotta wait for the red light to come on and the green light to come on. Red light meaning they're loading me, green light meaning they're done. This is kind of a different design. It looks like your DOT bumper comes in here, and then they want to use it to support the rear of the trailer as they go in and out with the forklift, and they got shocks in here help absorb some of the, so the trailer doesn't get beat up. You can see how it is over here. This is the older design, and it's got a hook. So if the driver had an idea to drive off, he couldn't drive off, he or she, because the hook would catch the trailer and rip the bumper off. That also is an accident report. Walk back and check things. Don't just trust the green light.